Hi guys, and welcome to another episode. Today I am sitting down with one of my favorites in the space, and that is Mr. Fred Noguera from PixEOS. Fredman, I think we should start this off by, I want you to show off your t-shirt.
Want me to show my t-shirt?
Okay. I need a break from reality.
Yeah.
How fitting, bro. I love it. I guess we can kind of kick off the interview by maybe just talking a little bit about some of the basic questions, like, who is Fred? How did you find EOS? What gave you the idea of PixEOS?
So Fred is an entrepreneur in the real world. So I run my event management company for 10 years. Been doing awesome events all over the world, dealing with some like really, really big multinationals for a long time. Telling a little bit about PixEOS, like, it came to life when I decided to create something that I love. Not that I don't love organizing events, I do love, but sometimes I need to deal with stuff that is not exactly my lifestyle kind of stuff. So I decided to create something that I love. I'm a musician in real life, so this is my artistic skill. And I'm an art collector for quite a while. So I love pop art, I love pop surrealism, I love surrealism. And I fell in love with blockchain 1 year and a half ago. So I bought my first Litecoins, I bought my first EOS in the ICO. Then I got close to the end of the year, and I was listening to everything, and I bought Ripple and I bought Tron. And then I was sitting on Christmas at home and I watched, like, boom, this is skyrocketing. Like, this is awesome, man. Why didn't I do this before? Right. And then I continued. I created my group, ICO analysis group for Portuguese speaking people. There was very few materials online about altcoins and ICOs, a lot about Bitcoin, but not about ICOs and altcoins. So we started a discussion there. It was a very healthy group, started to grow. We got to 300 people in the course of a month or 2 months, and then we continued. Then I joined another project, a cybersecurity project, as a moderator.
Yep.
Later down the line, they made a technical challenge to the community, and I put together a group of developers to do stuff for them. It was when I met Jorge Alcaril, our CTO, that is a beast of a coder. 6 months, thing just got to an end. And we decided that we needed to launch something else. We've seen the potential of the technical team. I knew my potential in the marketing and brand activation world. And we got together and started to brainstorm about what we would do next. We had like some very heavy sessions of brainstorming, and we finally came out to a messaging app that we would develop ourselves with everything that you cannot find in a messaging app right now. So we know that Telegram is amazing and awesome tool. It's evolving every day, but there are many stuff that they don't have. So we wanted to put everything in one app, and it was a super configurable, super complete messaging app. We made all the collaterals, white paper, one pager, pitch deck, and all of that stuff. Then the bear market hit. And then we lost all the support. We were already talking with VCs. We had a partner projects that all of a sudden they got, like, they made a huge campaign, and all of a sudden they had like a 10th or 20% of what they raised. So in that moment, we lost all the basis that we were building for that. And then I got into deep depression and I started to sit down, and I sat down and I started to think, what can I do next? Because, like, this is my dream, like, to develop something meaningful for this space, because I've been already analyzing, checking everything and seeing how things shouldn't be done. Because people sometimes, they come to our group and they ask, like, what you're doing is not right. I analyzed 100 ICOs before. No, you didn't, man. All of them they did wrong. Tell me, from the 100, 10 that thrived, yeah, that already delivered the tech.
If
10.
If
I want 10% of those 100 you analyzed that delivered the tech. Show me the tech working in the real world,
yeah,
people using their app, and not for tech people. I'm not here to please tech people. So if you understand about ICOs, or if you're a developer, I'm not here to please you, man. I'm here to please the crowds. to put EOS in the road of adoption, to put my dApps and my platform in the road of adoption, for people to come and ask to me, help me with an EOS account because your product is so awesome that I want you to use it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, man.
So then I came up with the idea to put the two loves of my life in one place, that was blockchain and art. And then blockchain plus art equals PixEOS.
And PixEOS was born. So I'm going to put you in this like hypothetical situation. Okay, we're going to give this, we're going to give you like this 12-year-old niece, and her name is going to be Anna, just for the sake of whatever. So Anna, Anna comes, she's 12, she says, Uncle Fred, what is PixEOS? How would you break that down for somebody who maybe didn't understand blockchain, or how would you break down the project for somebody who might not have a good grasp on EOS or on some of the technology behind blockchain, in simplest terms?
In simplest terms, so PixEOS is a place that you can get together with your art school friends or colleagues, and you can make art together, you can paint together, you can paint, but then you can make a mess that is what you love. So you can paint each other's stuff all over and over again, you can get dirty, you can do whatever you want, and then in the end, it doesn't matter the mess you make, we'll give you candies. So you can come, collaborate, and in the end, you still get some candies, right? So basically, that's what PixEOS is. And we are the art teacher that it's helping people to do something meaningful with a real-world application. And we'll tell them, like, if you put these candies here and you behave, we'll give you more candies. So if you don't take these candies from here, you get even more candies. And if you wait for us to finish the whole artwork, we'll give you even more candies. So you keep your candies here, reserved. Let's finish with our whole course. And in the end, you'll get a bunch of candies.
Kids love candy. And so why?
Yeah.
No, it's a good analogy. I really like it, man. Like, yeah. Of course, I reviewed your white paper last night. We started talking like quite a while ago, and I'm still blown away because how quickly you moved. Like, when we first started chatting, you were like, hey, I have this idea. And you were just kind of putting the finishing touches on the white paper. And it really wasn't that long ago. And now you've built this massive, inclusive community movement. You've got developers. You've got some really important people involved. The tech is being pushed through. Like, I'm just blown away at the speed at which you're moving. It's kind of like art meets games, meets staking, meets dividends. Like, you took the coolest parts of everything going on in the ecosystem and you put them together. How does that token economy, kind of in simple terms, how does that token economy work? And what are some of the principal uses of your token?
Yeah, so the economy works. We've been in the checking and playing and analyzing all the other dApps.
Yeah.
So I was in Pixel Master from day one. Katie remembers me, EOS Asia Katie remembers me from her beta test group before they delivered the game to the community to manage.
Yep.
Right. So I was in this initial very small group of people, like 12 people. I remember that she put 12 or 14 names on the EOS Asia wall saying like, these guys are my beta testers. And she's like super sweet. Like, I love Katie. She's amazing. And she was really engaging with us and telling, I can look forward. And then they started to explain how it worked. Blah, blah, blah. Then they needed for some reason to give it for the community to manage. And I started to play from day one. Pixel Master. I was playing like super, it was super fun. And, like, we had like this power hour when they activated the threshold to speed up the volume of the game. And we were every single day with the guys there, like sharing, making gift wars. And it was when I really felt like the first bloody blockchain group where I can share a gift. And I can make a GIF war with other people. And we can tell whatever we think of. And we're not censored, right? So we can be ourselves in a group playing an art game. And this is awesome. And in the end of the day, we get dividends.
Yeah.
Right? So I was like super hyped with that. It was the first time without my experience in blockchain. And I have quite a significant experience in blockchain, in the blockchain verse. It was the first time that I seen something working with an economy.
Yeah.
Right. And as we had this product before that we needed to try to put a working economy on it, this messaging dApp, it was very difficult for us. We couldn't come to a good economy for the dApp.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden Dice came. someone invited to the guys dice group. They had, I think, like 80 people in it or 100 people in it. So I was one of the very first to join the group. And I started immediately rolling the dice, because then I met the blockchain economy with PixEOS, and then I met the perfect tokenomics from dice, right? Yeah. That you could roll a dice, you could have a price. So it's like a loyalty program that you pay, you're paying something to roll a dice. You can win or lose, but at the same time, you're getting a bunch of that native token that is worth nothing. But just the feeling of getting those 100 dice in the first stage of the mining was amazing. It was cool. It was cool to see, like, this is token economy. It's not what all those ICOs were promising. But this is something that you go there as a person. Doesn't matter if you're a gambler. Doesn't matter if you're whatever, a whale or a tech guy or a non-tech guy. You're actually using tokenomics, and they work, right? They work in all aspects. You get the token, you can stake the token, you keep the token there, you're loyal to the platform, the platform gives you back. So it's profit sharing. If you don't overindulge, you make a good cash out of it. So I still go, I don't have time to roll anymore, but I still go there and I take like 3-4 ES per day from dice. And then I take a bunch of dice that I can stake, and then I
get
a little bit more next day. And right now I can get PixEOS. That was amazing.
You know, like, it's kind of funny because some people crap on it and they're like, oh, it's gambling or it's this or it's that. But for me, like, I think it's interesting, man. Like, it's one of my hobbies is going out and tracking down some of the new gambling dApps. I'm not like a huge gambler, but I definitely, like, I do love getting tokens and like watching the different token economies. And like,
You not even need to gamble to use dice.
No.
You can go to the exchange, you buy a big bag of dice, you go to the platform, you stake, you don't do anything else. You see ears raining to your
account.
So cool. you may not like them, but you need to respect them, because they develop in hyperspeed.
Yeah.
They are awesome. They've been improving their UX, they've been improving their UI. Man, it's crazy stuff. It's crazy stuff. For who's following and watching, and I got wrecked many times. I got into a couple of pre-sales, like putting like some significant sums of money. And I look at that right now, and I have $30, dude.
Yeah. Yeah.
Me and too. I put $5K, $10K in that bloody ICO. So when people come to my group, I analyzed 100 ICOs. Yeah, me too, man. And they made me wreck big deal because they don't have a proper tokenomics. Right? So, yeah. I'm very blunt, man. I'm sorry. I'm very honest, man. Yeah, I will always say what I think.
This is a safe place, Fred, man. You can say whatever you want. And if you want to drop an F-bomb, because I know you almost did, you're allowed. I won't. You're allowed here. No, man, I agree with you. And I think that the fact that you're kind of combining that in with like this new art economy is, I think it's really, really cool. And people can say whatever they want about gambling dApps. It's pushing
whatever, man.
Man, it's pushing
whatever. They're doing better than the real world, is what I used to say. Like, we have a lot of crap in blockchain.
Yeah.
When you start developing blockchain, you need to look what is out there. Can I be better than these guys, or at least as good as them? If you can't, don't do it.
Yep.
It's just my very honest opinion. So we need to improve. We need to unite. We can support each other to make the products in blockchain better. So we're all in to share experiences, to share what we learned after the platform is live. So people, they can come and ask us anything and compare us with the other ICO. They can do it 100 times. They can be arguing with me on the group as much as they can. We're not going to change. We're not going to change.
Don't change, man. I want to ask you about a couple of aspects of your token economy that are really cool. You've got number one, you can actually purchase digital artwork. As I saw in the white paper, that'll be kind of one of the things. And you can also contract an artist, right? How does this work? I think it's really cool because we're kind of doing something similar at Tribe, where eventually there's going to be a way that you can like contract somebody to do content for you for whatever it might be you want the content for. And this is the same thing, but it's like for art. And it's like artists can finally actually own like their piece of artwork and they can kind of sell it. Do you want to just break down how those two processes work?
Yeah. One. So we have two stuff that are very important in the platform, two components, right? Yeah. One is the NFT gallery, or the PixEOS gallery of non-fungible tokens. where you can actually, it's a curated gallery. So you have a KYA to come in, that is know your artist, right? So you need to prove through all the conventions from the real world. So we are backing as a big deal legally to do it. So the artists need to prove that that art is theirs. Yep. And we, at the first stage, because people, they like decentralization and so on, but you cannot have a real use case if you will not go get legal and stuff, right?
Sure.
So for you to have the outside world adoption, there will be a lot of work that we'll have to have all the conventions of the real world in our platform, right? So you make a KYA and you go in and then you put your artwork there and you tell, this is mine, I want to sell it, it's backed by an NFT, and it has a digital provenance encrypted in the blockchain, immortalized and immutable. So if I'll pass that art, we're not, when a part is like, we're not certifying images. Zero. You can put whatever you want. It can be shared wherever you want. What we're certifying is your rights over that piece.
Yeah.
Right. So yeah, people can share it everywhere, but if Matt goes there to our NFT gallery and buy a painting or buy a visual artwork or buy a creative media asset, you will know that it's yours until you have the NFT token in your wallet.
That's awesome.
Okay. And the moment that you sell it or you offer it to someone, that person will only own truly that image if you transfer the token to their wallet. And like this, I like one analogy that I'm using. Imagine if Da Vinci would have a PixEOS NFT when he painted Mona Lisa. We wouldn't have all the doubts about the origin. If it was corrected, if it was touched, if it was stolen and replaced by a forgery piece. So that is exactly what will happen. From this moment, you can always prove that you painted that art, that you sold that art, and you will prove the provenance probably in 100 years, that I believe that EOS will evolve and scale in 100 years, but this can even be swapped to another blockchain. It can even be whatever, you can fix the situation, but in 100 years, you still have this cryptographic proof of authorship and certificate. So I believe it solves a really big problem that we have right now with arts problems.
Yeah, I think it's a good solution. I'm just laughing at mostly at KYA because, of course, I work really closely with Wordly, so I deal with a lot of KYC, and it's just, I think it's, yeah, I love it. Yeah. And I think it's interesting, and I think that it's a really good way to go about it and make sure that the right people are
paid. Yeah.
Like, it's important, man. So, of course, once again, you know, we started talking quite a while ago when you were just kind of in the early stages of planning. And one thing that I have noticed at like lightning speed, you've just embedded yourself in the community. You actually, it's not even fair to say because you were already clearly embedded in the community, but you've rounded up some really, really strong partners who you're working with right now. And just your community is just exploding. Like, things are going really, really well from you, from everything that I can see. And I know that that's not just some, like, it's not just a bunch of flash. Like things are coming along really well. How important it was kind of choosing your partners? And I guess, like, as a kind of a secondary question to that, like, where is the draw? Why are all these people running towards PixEOS? Like, I mean, if you're to really break it down, like, what is the attraction? Like, why is everybody so into what you're doing?
Why is everybody so into what we're doing? Like, first, because we are transparent and crystal clear. From the beginning, we tell, and if you read our white paper, that we would compose or complete our team with community members, with awesome community members.
Yeah.
So, man, I believe a lot in fate and destiny. Like, things, they're just happening for us. Like, when I met Matt from Eosphere in the DICE group, we started to talk on DM. We became good friends. We were talking about many things. And all of a sudden, when I finally had the idea of PixEOS, I came to the guy and I told, listen, I have this project. And maybe it's awesome that we would talk about. Because only right now, after 2 or 3 weeks, I realized that you're from Eosphere. And I went and I Googled it. And I realized that they were a BP. And for me at that stage, as a fan of EOS, to be talking with someone from a BP was a huge stuff, right? And Matt is a super down-to-earth dude, and we're very good friends. We're calling each other, like, very often. We know that our families know each other. We know that we have a family, how they look like, and all this stuff. And then he connected me with Ross, and Ross was a hero and projected us all over, supported us all over. And I think like everything was connecting. Then we launched the project. People, they started to get interested. Stella Bell, that is a huge writer, artist, celebrity in the space, got interested in our concept. And I think the main thing is because we're not just developing technology in the blockchain. We are creating something for the people, right? Something that the people can come in and use. Okay. And we're honest about it. And we have all our heart into it. We're not just making this to cash out or making this to fill up our pockets. We don't need that. I'm an established businessman in the real world, so I can continue doing my shit there. So I believe in this. I love this. I love this. I love to be with the community. I love the community work. I love when the community is energized like we are. Like, there's no bear market in our group. We're always like having fun. They can be themselves. I remember when I was working as a moderator for other company, people, they couldn't post a GIF. They couldn't post a sticker. They couldn't comment about something else, their personal life, that they were frustrated, that they were depressed, that they needed someone to talk. They couldn't. Yeah. It was always, leave your personal problems out of here. If you post, you're warned. If you post a gift once again, I'm muting you. Yeah, I would do this with FUD. Like, FUD. I hate FUD. When you're working like 20 hours a day for a month and a half without one day off, if a FUDder come to my group without research, without going to our end channel, without looking to our partnership session of the website and researching about dudes that are there, that are good guys, that are doing a lot for the space, that created a lot, that have functional products, I don't accept FUD. So yeah. Then I'll mute and then I'll ban. So, but that's something people can be free. And I think we were missing this space in the blockchain world and the cryptoverse where people can come and be themselves. Because when you're yourself, you respect others and you get respected. So you don't need the administrator to come there and tell you cannot talk about this, because you will feel that you're not doing right talking about that. And if you're not a good guy, you just leave, because you know that you don't feel comfortable there. So bad guys, they don't deal with good guys. And there will be a point that we'll part ways because our philosophies don't match. Right. So I think it's all about letting people be who they are, involving the community as much as you can. So we had our sticker contest pretty early. We had a couple of days of the community and we launched the sticker contest, and people, they were participating awesomely. We have amazing results from the first sticker contest. And actually people that participate in the sticker contest and won the prize, they're right now, they're employees of PixEOS.
Yeah.
They're working for PixEOS on a daily basis. They're designing for PixEOS. They're getting paid, like properly paid before the raise. So we started to raise right now. Tokens are there. Real cash out is another thing that people are asking. And I would like to tell, like, we're not going to get wrecked. So people can come to our contract in a couple of days when we finish making everything that we need to check what we need for development, what we need to move for marketing, because we've been investing our money in the marketing campaign. We've been investing our money in the project. We made a smart contract before holding a sale. We had our token in the market. We were giving our token. We were engaging the community. We were talking with media, all of that before a raise, right? So, and I have friends that they launched blockchain projects this year, and they raised a handsome amount of money. And right now they don't have to develop because they didn't cash out.
Yeah.
Right? So don't come bash me in the wall when we'll prepare the company as a company and to roll and to manage the company as a company, because we are business dudes. We know how to roll and how to manage a company in the outside world. So that's basically it. Like, we have most of it covered. It was a deep research that we've done. Working with ICOs, we know everything that an ICO shouldn't do from the inside. So we've seen the ego trips of the CEO. We've seen the financial problems they faced. We've seen them spending multiple thousands in campaigns that were completely empty and not effective, right? So that's why we don't have a marketing department. We have PR and media partners that they will help us spread the word. The word, but we are the ones doing the whole campaign. It's all strategized, right? And everyone can come and ask in the group. Well, I'll be more than glad to answer to any questions as long as they're honest and as long they're not to put down a project that has everything out there for people to research. They can go through an honest man.
Of course, I'm involved in a few projects myself, right? And I don't blame you. Like, some people are coming there and they have legitimate questions and they want to know things. And then some people are there just because they're anonymous and they're having a shitty day. And they're looking to just be an idiot because it makes them feel good because their personal life is in shambles and they can't control anything outside of what's going on. Virtual attacks. Yeah. Like, I get it is what I'm trying to say. Like, I understand where you're coming from. If people have good questions and they want to ask things, but if they're just there to just try to destroy like some of the sanctity that you put together, and anybody can, like, we talked for an hour before, we've talked quite a few times before. I have a pretty good bullshit detector, Fred, and I will personally attest to people that I can read you pretty well. And I know that you're a good guy. You got good intentions. So there's no doubt about that on my behalf.
Yeah. Great. Now people will see the tech pretty quick. Like, we don't have 6 months to deliver. We were closing the sale about a week before the first step. So it will be, and before closing the sale, you and other guys and Rob and Ross and our strategic partners, our VC partner, all of them will be testing. So you can come to any of the strategic partners, go to their group and ask, are you actually testing this debt? And they will tell you before the sale is closed. Yeah, I'm testing this debt. It's awesome, or it sucks.
I will be testing the DAP. Hell yeah, for sure. Are you kidding me? That would be a huge
So everything's connected, dude. Everything's connected. We prepared this not to have to give time for people to guess about the project.
Yeah.
So what we're doing is real. We started with a movement. So we have a movement. You can just see our new video for the GIF competition. It's awesome stuff. It's awesome material.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have that. Like, we're teaching people, we're engaging people, we're giving our tokens, we're already sharing the profits that we're starting to have before we started to have the profits.
For sure. So I want to ask a question that kind of everybody's wondering. Let's talk about the staking mechanism and staking. Mm-hmm. Like, how exactly do you incorporate that with like a pixel-based art game? How does that kind of work?
Exactly like dice. You're taking, because you're paying for pixel, you get 100 pixels. Or you bought in the pre-sale and you get there, you just stake. The staking system will read them in your wallet and you will click the staking button and they will be staked. And from next day, you're getting dividends. Obviously, our game has different economy than a gambling DApp. So we have many other rewards in the DApp. So if you play every day, you have the 24-hour bonus. If you play every day, you have the 24 pots. We don't believe to have a pot as an illusion for people to run after the pot. So we're not putting a carrot in front of the rabbit for the rabbit or the dog or the horse to run after the carrot. We're putting an actual pot that as long as you play, you have participation from it every 24 hours, right? And then you have an all-time patron as well. It's pretty small, but it's something like you go in the canvas, you paint 5 years, and then you'll be always getting a small share of the game if it has volume. So we are kind of incentivizing every kind of people. The guy that played once and don't want to play anymore, the guy that only staked, and the guy that is playing every 24 hours like crazy because he sees that if the game has volume, he's getting from the patron, from the all time, from the pot, and from the staking system. And he's also mining PixEOS. So there are many ways. As long as you participate in the game, there are many ways to have returns. Not overindulging yourself, controlling your finances, checking the tokens that you're spending, if it's up to your possibilities, if you're not destroying your life because of the game. Because I know that people, they reacted really badly when they invested, when they bought a pixel in Pixel Master for, I think it was $18,000 or something, the central pixel. And obviously, when the game ended, this guy was really upset.
Yeah.
But it's not the game fault, dude.
Yeah.
It's not the developer fault. So don't overindulge. So if you know that you want to play a game and you can afford, if you have 100,000 EOS in your account and you want to spend 20,000 EOS in one pixel, it's your problem. It's not the developer fault. Like in DICE, if you want to roll 5,000 EOS per roll, it's your problem, dude. If you lose two or three in a row and get wrecked, it's your problem, man. So you need to be responsible for your actions, right?
Yeah.
So, it's how it rolls.
Yeah, no, it makes sense. I think you can't really blame the game when you're being reckless. And that's like the one thing that everybody has to realize too, is like when it comes to anything, man, like even when I'm investing, I assign like a certain risk category for certain things. You know what I mean? I've got like my things and I'm like, yeah, I'm super confident. That looks like it's a good project. It's going to go places. Like, and I'm going to locate that like a medium low risk factor. And I'm going to put some, but you never spend anything that you can't afford to lose. And it's particularly in a gambling dApp, or particularly if you're painting pixels, whatever you're doing. So
in any economy with dividends, and in any economy that you actually need to interact with the dApp,
yeah.
So doesn't mean that it's playing and selling cards, whatever it is, it can happen in any kind of game. You can have games that you have collectibles that they raise in price as the game goes. And one day the game can lose adoption when you stay with a $5,000 card in your hand. You cannot do anything about it because the game is not.
Yeah.
So you need to be responsible and know what you're doing.
Sure.
Basically, is it?
How are you going to, I do want to ask you though, like how will the future of PixEOS evolve? Like what kind of things are you going to do to keep it dynamic? We're not just talking about a game here. We're talking about like an ecosphere of like a bunch of different games.
We are talking about an ecosphere. If you knew what we already been discussing, like the core team and the partners, the people that we're talking in the ecosystem, it will evolve to something like really, really cool. We have a first roadmap. We're not close there because I never believed in the long, lengthy tech white papers that you put everything that you do in the face of the user and it stops there. No, it doesn't stop there. So it's as scalable as possible. We can get into any kind of game after the first stage of the roadmap. We'll probably, and this is a disclosure I'm making here, we'll probably fork the platform by the end of the year. And we'll have a pure platform for games that started with art games and can evolve for any kind of games based in blockchain. And we'll have a purely business, art business oriented platform where we'll keep the marketplace, we'll keep the auction house, we'll keep the NFT gallery, and we will evolve to many other stuff. So the business will fork, and we will have two PixEOS platforms with different market targets.
Yeah, it's kind of like your art collecting kind of comes into play there, in the sense that, you know, the business side will be more of a marketplace for people who are looking to, you know, purchase or sell like real digital artwork. So it's you know, it's really cool that you've got all these different paradigms working. And I really recommend that everybody goes out and checks out your white paper, because it's really well explained and it's really well broken down, like your vision and kind of what you're doing. So I have no doubt that it's going to be like dynamic and you're going to come up with some really, really cool things.
Yeah, and we're really reactive. Like when someone comes to the community and make like significant questions, we're all into writing articles. So people, they were guessing what is a featured artist. We put out an FAQ about the featured artist with everything, with legals, with common, like with public domain, with everything that we're doing, how we're doing, how you can become a featured artist, what you need to know to be a featured artist, and what you can do and what you cannot do, right? So everything, every question or everything that is significant, we're writing an article and put it out. So if people take a little bit of time to go to our announcement channel or to come to the group and tell, do you have any material explaining that?
Yeah.
We'll be very honest and we'll tell, here you have this article, please have a read. Oh no, we don't have, it's not time for you to know.
Yep.
Ah, how is not time for you to know? You're not being transparent. No, I am being transparent, but I have a business plan that most of the projects don't, right?
Yeah.
So I will follow my business plan. It doesn't matter what you think. I'm sorry for the users to be so blunt, but it's all for the sake of the community. It's for the sake of the product, for the sake of adoption. People ask me why we're not open source. Because we are not open at this stage. We will show it to the watchdogs. We will show it to Block One if they ask. We will show it to Tribe if Tribe will tell, let me look at your contract because I want to know that is real. Like we've shown to CypherGlass.
For sure.
And we have a developer suggested by CypherGlass that looked and worked with us in our sale contract.
Yeah.
So if you have any technical doubts about PixEOS, just go and ask our strategic partner.
Yeah.
Right? Like we've been talking with EOSphere developers that will probably jump on board in the moment that we're ready for them to intervene. We already have a team, a highly capable team of developers working that and experienced in EOS smart contract. And led by a beast of a coder, that is Giorgio Carillo. So yeah, basically this is the structure of PixEOS, and it's not bragging, it's just how things are. I think when things are like this, they're like this, and we're here to prove to the strategic partners, to people in the ecosystem that matters, not to the user that come to FUD. So this, I want to make it pretty clear. Then the users need to wait. We have like so cool gadgets coming out. We're putting a widget next week for people to play around. I think you have a look at it. I have showed you already. Yeah. So everything's planned. Like people so far, they had a designer kind of stuff. And from now on, they will manage to do it themselves. So like we're always bringing new things on the table and on the ecosystem and presenting new paradigms to people.
I definitely have zero doubts about your integrity. You work with a lot of people that I respect a lot. And honestly, man, like we've been talking for a long time, so I know you're doing the right things. I know you're going to do the right things. I know PixEOS is going to be huge. I also know that you have a token sale going on. So for anybody who wants to participate in that token sale, how can they do that, Fred?
How can they do that? They just need an EOS account.
Yep.
If they don't have one, they can come to our group and ask for one. We had a bot distributing EOS account codes for free. It's a partnership that we have with Token Pockets, one of our partnered wallets. Yep. But as many things that happen in blockchain, people were abusing it. So I had one guy coming and taking 50 accounts. So it's 49 people that didn't join the EOS ecosystem because of a dude that is getting accounts to sell it somewhere else or to make a good figure to his friends or to just brag around that I have 50 free account codes, come and get it, right? So we stopped with the bots. So the abuse was too big. We gave a lot of genuine and legit account codes or to legit people, but I would say that like 50 to 60% of the codes, they were taken by bots. They were taken by people creating multiple accounts. So we stopped that. So people for right now, for people to get their account, they need to come to us and they need to open a conversation with us. We need to see their handle. So if they don't have a public handle or explain who they are and prove that they are a real person, we're not giving out.
Still pretty cool that you're giving away accounts.
This costs money. This costs money to our project. This costs money to our partner project, partnering wallet. So yeah, we're not doing that anymore. So, and we are not going to brag like we gave 100,000 accounts and 90,000 was for bots that are distributing or selling them everywhere for half the price. So we're not sponsoring this kind of stuff, but we still have the philosophy like is in our white paper. As long as we have people wanting to join, we'll give them a free EOS account.
It's amazing.
And we are developing, we're thinking about developing because we don't have time to develop anything else right now. We're pretty busy with the game and pretty busy with the platform and other stuff that we had in the roadmap before. But we will develop a way to give people free account codes and know that they're real people. So we're able to do it.
Fred, I want to know, like, what's the perfect version of success? Like, PixEOS is an absolute hit. How do you see it in your head? Because I think you're the kind of guy who takes the time to visualize things. Like, how is the perfect... What's the perfect version of success for PixEOS?
The perfect version or vision?
Vision.
The perfect vision of success. I think we already got there. The perfect vision of success is to have five groups on WeChat, to have two big groups on WeChat, to have like 30 Bihu writers talking about us and wearing our pixel avatar, to have a great, super fast growing community in Korea, to start a community in India, to have an amazing group on Telegram where 99.9% of the users are just amazing people, interacting, having fun, sharing gifts, participating in the gift wars, understanding our concept, that we're different, that we're not there to pretend, we're there to be ourselves. Right? So yeah. We already achieved that. I don't have any other vision. I think things will happen from now on naturally. We need to deliver a great tech, right? And we know that, and we're working hard for that, and we're surrounding us with great people to do it. We need to keep on doing our very natural marketing stuff because everyone is doing what they love.
Yeah.
Like Stella Bell is making amazing videos and gifts because it's what she loves to do. She's not moderating in a boring channel of an exchange or protocol or something. So she's doing what she loves. Most of the people there, they're doing like what she loves. We have an amazing artist that is Fabi Yamada. She's from Mexico. She's the true pixel artist. She's doing just freaking awesome stuff, man. She just put me dancing with Voxy, our bot, in the 3D animation where you see everything, the lightning, the shadows, and everything. It's amazing work. So it's super talented people that we have working with us, highly motivated, because they were not considered like as an important human workforce or talent before. They were just working, doing websites. And they told me, my dream is to do this for a living. You're giving me the opportunity to be a pixel artist for a living. And I'm being paid for that every month, right? So yeah, that's what we achieved. We're helping people. We're like just trying to feed their dreams and give them tools to fly. That's what we want. We want people to look at PixEOS and see that it's a place where you can be yourself. And if you are prepared to join, you're ready. We're ready to welcome you. Like we are two founders, and now we are 15 people all around the world.
It's amazing, buddy.
From different nationalities, different languages. Like I think we can speak almost everything or anything. If someone will come and speak Chinese, we have someone answering. If someone will come and speak Korean, Italian, Portuguese, Spanish, you can come. Just come. You're welcome. Like our end channel will be always international. We'll be sharing everything there in Chinese, Korean, and English right now because it's the actual communities we have. So we have achieved a lot. We have 16,000 token holders. Known whale proportions. Our biggest holders are our strategic partners. So if you see our top five of holders, three are strategic partners. So I think everything was like built in the way that we expected. And right now it's just to continue to follow our roadmap, our plans, our marketing strategy, and making EOS as mainstream as we can. So put EOS out there. Like I was like super baffled when I went to Cointelegraph. We were the first app to be featured in Cointelegraph. And I searched EOS and I seen one page. You search Bitcoin and you see, I don't know, I don't remember, I will not tell a number, but multiple pages of Bitcoin. Yeah. So or we start to move as a community united, stop thinking that we get there because we didn't, and fight harder and stronger to have what we deserve. Because if we grow EOS to 6 million people, everyone will benefit. 100%. So everyone will benefit. Everyone will have something in return. Everyone will have profits. Everyone will sell products. Everyone will have more and more community members that will get into the community, understand how we are. Because it's really cool to see the EOS community. You know everyone. So you know the guy that is creating a problem, you know the guy that is a pain in the neck, you know the guy that is amazing and super energetic and super positive. So you know everyone. And this is something that we have very positive that we can grow sustain in a sustainable way. Then we can keep the scams out, the impersonations out, the signal sharing out, because we know how things roll. So if one guy will come and start doing those things, the community will self-control. So it's a contained universe that Ethereum, for example, doesn't have. You put a dApp in Ethereum, dude, you need to spend hundreds of thousands to get adoption because it's all spread around. So over there, and we have a beautiful ecosystem where you can launch a dApp and have adoption right away because you have a beautiful community. And then we just need to be prepared to bring more people in. It's not ours. It's everyone's. So this blockchain is proving that you have a beautiful ID system. It's easier for you to join than to buy in an e-commerce website. I was asking friends, like, please, here you have an account code, here you have instructions, tell me if it's difficult or not. And it's super simple. You don't need to put your address, you need to put your IRS number, you need to put your picture or connect to your credit card, and they fill up your credit card details and go to the 3D secure to approve, and then you come to your cell phone and you see the code and you put your 3D secure code. So don't tell me that blockchain is complicated. Blockchain and EOS blockchain is super easy. The human readable account codes is amazing.
I agree.
It's just a matter. We need to do our part. We're not doing our part.
Yeah, I agree. I am going to ask you, first of all, I'm going to make sure that I list everything about PixEOS. Because honestly, Fred, I really love you. I love what you're doing. I'm going to list your, of course, all your various social medias. I encourage people to go into your Telegram. I really encourage people to take a look at your white paper. It's awesome. I think it really kicks ass. But before I let you go, I want to ask you one last parting question. If you could pixelate anything into the sky, anything for the whole world to see, what would that be?
EOS is awesome.
EOS is awesome. EOS is awesome, my friend. Fred, it's an absolute pleasure to talk to you. I hope that we get the chance to talk again sometime soon. Anytime you have anything going on, please reach out, hit me up. Of course, man, I'm you know, proud to have you as a partner on Tribe, and I just hope we can continue to kind of bring up.
I will, man. We're together, man.
Yeah, we are. Honestly, Fred, I love what you're doing. You're going to be successful. I have zero doubt, and I'm looking forward to watching it all.
No, dude, I love what you're doing too, man. It's I think it's a huge contribution. It's like guys like you or guys like us that will drive the ESG adoption. So it's what I used to say, man, we're on the road to adoption. So let's unite, let's fight, let's do the right stuff. We're all in. So people can come to our project. Like, I need help. I need a tip. How are you doing this? I think it's so awesome. I want to do in my project. We're not charging advisory because in some things we're really, really experienced. I wouldn't say that we're good, we're experienced. And yeah, it's there for the ecosystem. We're here to contribute.
I love it, buddy. You have yourself an amazing night, and I look forward to talking to you again soon.
Thank you so much, buddy. Okay, it was amazing to talk to you, buddy. You have a good day. I'll have a good night. It's time to go for my power nap.